So I was asking, is there any difference between the vacation and break? Vacation and break, is there any difference? Tell me. The upcoming Dashera is a vacation or a break? If it is a vacation, tell yes. It's a vacation. All right. Okay. Anyways. So, the 10 days which are there in front of you, that is an opportunity for someone who really want to get ahead and do better. Okay, magic won't happen that you're sleeping and some magic will happen and suddenly you'll be ahead of everybody else. That won't happen. So, it is not compulsory. Like, if you really want to do better than others, here is an opportunity because nothing will happen in school, nothing will happen in Centum for probably 7 or 10 days. So there is an opportunity for you to focus on your weak areas and get ahead. It's your choice if you want to do it. Okay. How many of you are planning to go outstation during the vacation? No one, right? Everybody will be in the home only. No one will go. Corona effect. I think this corona will be there for 2, 3 years now. The kind of attitude that is there right now, this change will there. People will adapt to it. Anyways, we will get ahead with our last physics class before your so-called vacation starts. Fine. So last session we have discussed about the torque equation, right? So I'll quickly recap all that. Fine. And today the agenda is that I'll not teach very heavy concept. Okay. In fact, I'm going to solve a lot of questions with you. All right. So, and then I'll be going it little slowly also so that you can understand in a much better manner. If you like, here is an opportunity that if you haven't understood the torque concept, you please ask doubts. If you don't ask doubts, I will not get a dream that you have certain doubts and you don't know something, so I should tell that again. Okay, so if you get stuck somewhere, immediately let me know, we'll discuss it. So this is an opportunity for you. I think some of the students' vacations already started. 7, 8 students haven't come in today's session. All right, write down. Today is also a focus on torque only. Torque equation. All right. What is a torque equation? Can anybody quickly type in? Torque equation is what? Respond quickly, okay? So that will type in the torque equation. FR sine theta. What else? Okay. That is not the torque equation, that is the definition of torque. Torque equation is tau is equal to I alpha. That is a torque equation. Okay. So when you say force into perpendicular distance, that is the definition of torque. That is not an equation. All right. So the torque equation is tau equals to I alpha. When I can apply this, when I can apply this equation? How can I apply this equation? Where? What is the condition? Anyone? Only about the fixed axis. That's all. So this equation is valid for a rigid body. Okay, and I is the moment of inertia about the fixed axis. All right, if I is, let's say, fixed axis, this equation is valid or not? This equation is valid for the fixed axis. All of you agree? Now, moment of inertia is about the fixed axis. What about torque? Torque is about same fixed axis. Remember that. You find out torque about the same fixed axis and equate that to moment of inertia about that axis into alpha. All right. And you know torque is equal to perpendicular component of force into distance, or perpendicular distance into force, right? So if you look at the diagram, I think we have made it here clear. So F r sin theta it is, you can see that perpendicular component of force is F sin theta. So F sin theta into r is torque. You can read it like that. You can also read it as F into r sin theta. What is r sin theta? R sin theta is the perpendicular distance on this line of force. So when you drop a perpendicular on this line, okay, this angle is theta, this distance is perpendicular distance, which is r sin theta. Fine. So you can write the torque equation as F sin theta into r, or r sin theta into F. Both ways you get the same value. There is a lag. Is there a lag when I speak? When I write, there is a lag. Okay, let me do some magic. And here goes the lag. Now, let me write something, then only you'll understand. Tell me, is there a lag now? Lag is gone? Okay, good. Fine, so you all understand, right? Torque is equal to perpendicular component of force into distance, or perpendicular distance into force, both ways. Fine. Now you can, no Kinshuk, there is no lag. Check your internet speed. So now torque is a vector quantity. One direction we take positive, other direction is negative. Which direction typically we take as positive for the torque? Or tell me how you define the definition of, how you define the direction of torque? How you define the direction of torque? What it is? Direction of torque is the direction in which it is trying to rotate. Getting it? Direction in which a torque is trying to rotate. Now, same force can have clockwise or anti-clockwise torque, depending on about which axis you look at. Suppose you look at this force, okay, with respect to, let's say, this axis. The axis that comes out of your plane, with that axis, this force will try to rotate clockwise or anti-clockwise about this axis. Clockwise, all of you understand? Now, about this axis, which way it is trying to rotate? About the second one. Anti-clockwise, right? So same force can produce both anti-clockwise and clockwise torque. You have to see with respect to what axis. In this chapter, everything depends on the axis. Fine. So be very sure about it. Now, is this equation valid only for the fixed axis? No, this equation is also valid about the center of mass axis. Then I is equal to ICM alpha, okay? Now tell me one thing, if I use, let's say there is a rod, okay? Suppose there is a rod like this, okay? This rod is fixed at this point and it can rotate about that axis. So there is a fixed axis, all right? So you have a force, let's say passing through the center of mass. There is a force, fine. So the torque with respect to center of mass is how much? Sorry, torque with respect to the axis of rotation is how much? About the fixed axis, what is the torque? This is perpendicular. What is the value of torque about the fixed axis? F into perpendicular distance, L by 2, right? This is equal to moment of inertia about the fixed axis, which is how much for the rod? About one of the ends, moment of inertia of the rod is how much? ML square by 3. By now you should be knowing it. ML square by 3 into alpha. Okay. This is writing the equation about the fixed axis. Now, same equation, torque equal to I alpha, I can write about the center of mass axis also. Center of mass is here. This is the center of mass. What is the torque about the center of mass? Tell me. Can you find out torque about the center of mass? Torque due to this force is how much? About the center of mass. Zero, no perpendicular distance. So which force is creating torque about this point, about the center of mass? Is there any force to create the torque about that point? The hinge forces, from where it is tied, there will be some hinge forces which we do not know. Let's call it as Fx and Fy. Okay, if you find out Fy, the point where it is fixed, that point the pin will apply force. All right, we need to find out what is Fy. Okay, so what is the torque due to Fy? Fy into L by 2. This is equal to ML square by 12. Now we have to use moment of inertia about center of mass into alpha. Okay, so my question is, for the same object, if you use the equation about the fixed axis and about the center of mass axis, will you get the same alpha or different alpha? Because torque and I are different about fixed axis and about the center of mass axis. What about alpha? Will alpha also depends upon which axis you're finding? Which axis you are writing the equation? Everyone, type it. Will alpha also depend upon which axis you are writing torque equal to I alpha equation? Quickly, I'm waiting. You don't need to solve something. What do you think? That's what I'm asking. Don't tell me you don't think anything. Yes, alpha remains same. Fine. Alpha will be same. Doesn't matter whether you write the equation about the center of mass or about the fixed axis. Alpha for a rigid body is fixed about any axis. Alpha, omega, and change in angle, they are same for all points on the rigid body. Okay, remember that. Fine. So this is with respect to torque equation. You can use a torque equation for a rigid body which is rotating. So in a question, you need to find out, okay, which object is rotating and about, and for that object, you can use the torque equation to find alpha. All right. Now, for a rigid body, you can use net force along x-axis is equal to mass times total mass of rigid body into acceleration of center of mass along x-axis. And similarly, about the y-axis and about the z-axis. All right. So whatever you have learned in Newton's second law chapter or laws of motion chapter, everything is valid in for the rigid body also. But acceleration is of the center of mass. Fine. Now we need to also find out relation between movement of different points on rigid body. Why such a thick? Okay, so this will help us to visualize better, because the Newton's second law equation for a rigid body will give me acceleration of center of mass, right? And torque equation will give me alpha. What if I am interested in finding the acceleration of some other point? All right. What I'm trying to say is this. For example, if you have a rigid body like that, this is a rigid body, okay? It is rotating about the fixed axis. This is the axis about which it is rotating. Its angular acceleration is alpha. Fine. Total length is L. Okay. Now, you have to tell me what is the acceleration of this point, which is at a distance of x away. The distance of x away, what is the acceleration of that point? This point. Suppose it has just started rotating. Omega is almost zero. So what is the acceleration of that point in terms of alpha? No one knows how this point is moving. Everyone, is this point moving in a circle? Tell me, is this point moving in a circle or not? With respect to this fixed axis point, it is moving in a circle, right? It is moving in a circle. All right. And it is moving in a circle with angular acceleration of alpha. So what is the acceleration of this point? It will be tangential, first of all, right? It will be tangential. So what is that acceleration? Any object that is moving in a circle, let's say this point, suppose there is a point that is moving in a circle. This is, let's say, small angle d theta. This distance is r d theta by definition of angle. Okay. So my distance is r d theta. We have done all of this. When you divide by dt, you will get speed of the particle, which is r into omega. All right. When you differentiate it again, you'll get du by dt is equal to r times d omega by dt. What is d omega by dt? What is this d omega by dt? Alpha. So this is r alpha and this is acceleration. All right. So acceleration of any point which is moving in a circle of radius x and angular direction alpha, tangential direction of acceleration is alpha into x. Everybody understood this? If you find the center about which a point is moving in a circle, then the acceleration of that point in tangential direction is alpha into x. Type it quickly. Have you understood this? Now tell me, if angular velocity of this rod is omega, so how much is the acceleration towards the center? This acceleration is how much? It is moving in a circle. Forget about the entire rod. Just focus on that point. That point is moving in a circle. Point P. Although it is a part of rigid body, forget about that fact. So it is omega square x. So any particle that moves in a circle will have an acceleration towards the center, which is omega square r. That is what it is. R is x, right? And tangential direction, it is alpha into x. Sometimes in uniform circular motion, alpha is zero. So only acceleration is centripetal. But in this chapter, alpha won't be zero. Fine. All right. But then here we assume throughout the chapter till now that we are talking about the fixed axis, right? What if the object doesn't have a fixed axis? All right. For example, you have this. There is this rod lying on a horizontal table, okay, which is moving forward. The acceleration of center of mass is given to us. This acceleration of center of mass in this direction is acm. That is given. And while moving, it is also rotating with angular acceleration alpha. Fine. Getting it? Now, I want you to tell me, what is the acceleration of a point P which is at a distance of x away? At a distance of x away, what is the acceleration? Tell me. Anyone? Acceleration of point P, which is at a distance x away, if the point is same as in the figure. What? What are you saying, Kinshuk? Like that. Yeah, right now you tell me what is acceleration. Nobody else, only Kinshuk got it. Okay. All right. Now tell me, relative. Relative to center of mass, what is the acceleration of point P? This you answer. How much it will be and in which direction? Relative center of mass. When we find out relative acceleration, we make that point as if it is at rest. You stand there and watch the rod. With respect to center of mass, how this rod is moving, everyone? Relative to center of mass, what this rod is doing? What What is this rod doing relative to center of mass? It is, don't you think it is spinning about the center of mass? If you just look at with respect to center of mass, relative to it, it is just spinning. All the points, they are rotating with respect to center of mass in a circular path. Do you all agree to this? Type in. I am telling you something which is very, very important. These things are skipped when things are taught in everywhere else. Okay. So relative to center of mass, all the points are moving in a circle. Okay. With what angular acceleration? With what angular acceleration? Is there any angular acceleration of all the points are moving in a circle, right? So with what angular acceleration they are moving? Is there an angular acceleration first of all? If yes, what it is? Center is going in a straight line or not? Everyone, center is going in a straight line. Is there any angular acceleration of center of mass? No. So relative acceleration of all the points, relative angular acceleration is alpha only. All right. So all the points are rotating with an angular acceleration of alpha. So this point P relative to the center of mass is going backwards. With what acceleration? This point P relative to center of mass, which is at a distance of x, moving in a circle with alpha. So what is the tangential acceleration of that point? Alpha x, alpha into x, right? So relative to center of mass is this acceleration. So absolute acceleration is what? Absolute acceleration, how will you find? With respect to center of mass, it is alpha x. So how will you get the true value of it? For example, I'll tell you a scenario, then you will understand better. For example, this object is going with 5 meters per second. This object is going with 2 meters per second forward. So relative to this object, relative to object 2, what is the velocity of object 1? Relative to object 2? 3, right? So you know the relative velocity, let's say, is 3 meters per second relative to an object that is going forward with 2 meters per second. So what do you do to find the true velocity? If you already know the relative velocity, you add the velocity of an object with respect to which you are finding. Similarly here, with respect to center of mass, which is going that way, the acceleration is alpha x backwards. So in order to find the total acceleration, you need to add the acceleration of center of mass to it in that direction. So this is ACM. All right. So acceleration of point P is ACM minus alpha x in this direction, taking that direction positive. All of you understood this? This is extremely important, whatever I have just discussed. And everyone understood this? Type it quickly. Okay, let me give you one more scenario. See, we are not doing theory, okay? We are solving numerical like a theory. There is a difference. So suppose you have a rod, all right? This rod is making angle, let's say this angle is theta. Okay, it's angle theta. And the total length is L, mass is M. This point is center of mass. This point is L by 2, mass is uniformly distributed. Okay, the rod is rotating in this direction, this way, with alpha angular acceleration. All right, and the rod is also moving forward. The center of mass is accelerating with ACM. Fine. You need to tell me what is the acceleration of the tip. Fine. You need to find out what is the acceleration of the tip in the perpendicular direction of the rod. So basically, I am asking you what is the acceleration of the tip in this direction, perpendicular to the rod. In this, do it. Okay, Archit got something. Sudhanava Kashyap. Is that the name of the student? First time I'm... That's your dad's name. Brothers. Okay. Anyways, so over here, what is the acceleration in this with respect to center of mass? Relative to center of mass. What is the acceleration of the tip? What is the acceleration of the tip? Relative to the center of mass, what is the acceleration of the tip P? And in which direction? It is alpha into L by 2, alpha into L by 2. Which direction it is? Everyone, which direction it is? Will it be perpendicular to the rod in this direction only? Along this direction only, which is shown like this? Everyone? See, you need to understand that the tip is moving in a circle with the center at the center of mass, right? It is like that. Okay. Okay, approximately I have drawn. So this tip with respect to center of mass is going in a circular path. So the acceleration of this tip will be tangential like this along the tangent direction of circle, which is this, right? Now total acceleration, when you find, you need to add the acceleration of the center of mass also, which is this. Right? And you may or may not be aware that there is a centripetal acceleration also, since it is rotating, which is omega square L by 2. But I don't want this to come in. So I am interested only in the component that is perpendicular to the radial acceleration. All right. So if this is theta, this is also theta. You can check that. This is ACM. No, sorry, that is not ACM. The above one is ACM. So total accretion is alpha into L by 2 plus ACM into cos theta. That is perpendicular to the rod. All right, so these things you need to be very familiar with, and there is no escape to it. Fine, you must understand. Otherwise, you know, this chapter will give you a hell lot of trouble. Okay, you need to understand these things. Yeah, why centripetal acceleration is there? Centripetal acceleration is there because a point is accelerating with the angular. Centripetal acceleration of this point is there because it is going in a circle, right? That is the reason why. Only this point's acceleration I'm telling. Fine. But if the center of mass, write down, goes in a straight line, there is no net centripetal acceleration on the rigid body as a whole, total. Okay, and if center of mass moves in a circle of radius r, all right, then there is a centripetal acceleration of omega square r for the center of mass. Here I'm talking about the center of mass. Fine. So if there is a point that goes in a straight line, if center of mass doesn't move in a circle, of course there will not be any centripetal acceleration for the center of mass. Okay. But for the point, there is. The point is moving in a circle. All right. You need to detach the circular motion from the rigid body. Fine. So now write down a very, very important topic, rolling. Tell me, what are the kind of objects that can roll? Objects that can roll. A sphere can roll. Only sphere. Ring, disc, cylinder. A sphere, ring, disc, and cylinder. These objects can roll. Cone. Will you use cone in your bike? No, right? So, of course, then anything can rotate, fine. But then we are not interested in the irregular shape object. We are interested in an object which looks circular. If you look from the cross section, it should look circular. So basically, we are talking about rolling of a sphere, disc, ring, and cylinder. Fine. Now, rolling is a very, very important concept, because rolling has actually changed our lives. If rolling was not there, we could not imagine the modern day travels by using bikes, the cars, the trains. All those things are not possible. They are possible because rolling friction is less. It is very less compared to sliding friction. Fine. So because rolling creates lesser amount of friction, it is a preferred way of going from one place to other. All right. How much friction and all that, we will discuss that. So hold on. Now I'll show you. For example, you have, let's say, a disc. All right. You have a disc. You can say a sphere, ring, whatever you may want to call it. There is this disc. Fine. This disc is rolling. What is component? Lesser? Compared. Even I got confused. This is compared. Fine. So you have, let's say, a disc of mass M and radius R. All right. It is moving in such a manner that the center of mass has the velocity as VCN. All right. And it has an angular velocity like this. Now tell me, when it rolls, angular velocity will be like that or like this? Which one do you think will happen when it rolls and moves forward? That way it will roll or this way it will go? What do you think? Omega 1, right? That you're telling from your experience, right? So let's say this is a rolling scenario. All right. Now, there can be two kinds of movement for the disc when it is rolling. One is rolling without slipping. And second is rolling with slipping. So have you experienced them when you, let's say, ride a bicycle? Have you ever experienced rolling with slipping? It is rolling also and slipping also. Have you experienced that? Many times, so Kinshuk still experiences that. So now rolling without slipping and rolling with slipping, both can happen. But rolling without slipping is a constrained motion. This is a constrained motion. Now I want you to tell me what is the constraint when that happened. What is the criteria? Forget about omega and V and everything else. If you crack this, it is good enough. Tell me, what is the criteria for rolling without slipping? Slipping should not happen. So what should be there actually? What should be happening? What is the condition for it? Friction. No, friction is actually required. Friction, if it is not there, do you think your bicycle will roll if there is no friction on the roads? What is the condition? Sudhana, Sudhanva. No one? Tell me what should happen at point of contact. Rotation of the edge is equal to velocity of body. What does it mean? Acha, tell me. Forget about the rotation also. Here are the two surfaces. When one surface slides on the other surface, what is the condition that one surface slips on the other surface? What is the condition? No friction? Are friction is there? Not there is friction between the two hands. Still it is sliding. Still it is sliding. Not about the force. I am not asking anything related to force. I am asking related to the movement. What should be the condition? Tell me relation with respect to their velocities, their accelerations. Is there any relation between velocity and acceleration? Velocity of one hand is more than the other. Clear? There should be some relative velocity. All of you agree to that? There should be some relative velocity. Between both the hands, velocity of one of the hand should be more than the other. Then only sliding will happen. All of you agree to this? Quickly tell me. Right? Now, here is a point of contact. Here is a point of contact where this point of contact at the point of contact at the point of contact if velocity of the disc is equal to velocity of the surface, then tell me whether there will be slipping or no slipping. There will be slipping or no slipping. No slipping. Simple. No slipping. Right? Now tell me, with using VCM and omega, what is the velocity of point of contact of the disc? Tell me, what is the velocity? Just like we found out the total acceleration, similarly find out the total velocity. What it is? Along the direction, horizontal direction, what is the net velocity? VCM and omega, in terms of that, you find out. With respect to center of mass, it goes backwards. With what velocity? Omega into r. And you have to add the velocity of the center of mass this way. So this is VCM. So total velocity is VCM minus omega r. This should be equal to what? Velocity of the surface, which is how much? In this case, how much? Zero. It is at rest. Okay? It is at rest. So from here, you'll get VCM is equal to R omega. You got a constant equation. This is a constant equation. If I differentiate it, what I'll get? If you differentiate this, what you will get? With time you differentiate, dvcm by dt is equal to r d omega by dt. What is that? Dvcm by dt is equal to r. What do you get? This is what? This is acm is equal to r alpha. Please remember this constraint. This is a constraint equation. All right, and this will come again and again. They will tell you that how they will tell you that rolling without slipping is happening. They will either write that it is rolling. They'll write like this: rolling without slipping. They'll write, or they will say pure rolling. Okay, like this they'll say. Fine. If they write like this, you have a constraint equation for the rolling. Condition for pure rolling you have to write. Okay. Now there is a thumb rule that if there is a rolling going on a fixed surface. So if if there is a pure rolling, on a fixed surface, does not matter orientation of the surface. Whether surface is like this and you have your disk like that, whether the surface is like this and your disk is like that, as long as the surface is fixed, you can write blindly what ACM is equal to R alpha. Surface is fixed. All right. But surface can move also. For example, in this case, suppose you have a case like this. This one. All right. This is going this direction. Nay, let me move it in other direction. It is going in this direction with acceleration A1. This is a cylinder, let's say sphere. It actually doesn't matter. It's a sphere whose acceleration of center of mass is ACM, and it is having angular acceleration like this, alpha. All right. Tell me, what is the condition so that pure rolling is happening over here or no slipping is there at the point of contact? Tell me. Gayatri got something, Archit, others. Second object, center of mass doesn't matter. Okay. Ritu, is Shashank helping you? Right now, okay. All right, all of you tried, get the relation. Okay. Now, here, with respect to center of mass, what is the acceleration of this point? Which direction? Alpha r in which direction? Right or left? With respect to center of mass. How is left? Left kaise? It is right. Is rotating like that? Look at the sense of rotation. It goes like this and comes back like that, right? All of you understand that this is alpha r. Understood? Type in quick. Now, why, what happened, Kinshuk? This plus ACM is a total acceleration, right hand side. But acceleration of the block is A1, and I'm saying that there is no slipping, right? So what should happen is that alpha r plus ACM should be equal to negative of A1. They are in opposite directions. All right. So alpha r plus ACM plus A1 should be equal to 0. If A1 would have been in this direction, then these two are equal. I don't need to put negative sign. But they're in opposite direction. Now, how can this be true? Everyone, tell me. How can this be true? Adding three quantities, how can they add up to 0? Don't worry, Shraddha. We are going to do a lot of questions. This thing will come again and again. All of you answer me, how can three quantities gets added and equal to 0? The answer is 1 or 2 quantities are in different directions than shown. So what will happen is, there's nothing wrong with the equation, okay? There's nothing wrong with the equation. You can imagine it like this. When you solve the question, you will probably get alpha to be equal to minus 5 like that. You will not get a positive number for one or two quantities. And probably A1, you'll get minus 2 like that. Okay, and ACM, you'll get a positive quantity, maybe plus 10 or something like that. Fine. So you have to maintain the consistency in the equation. That's it. Do not start thinking that how can three quantities be add up to 0? One or more may be negative. Negative means in the opposite direction. That's it. Fine. But you have to maintain that at a point of contact, the velocity of both the objects should be same for no slipping. Fine. Anyone has any doubt? Anyone has any doubt? Clear? Okay. Good. So now we are good to solve questions. Fine. So here is the first question. You have an inclined plane that is fixed. Fine. This inclined plane has angle of theta. Okay. Then you have a sphere. You have a sphere of mass m and radius r. Okay. So there is no slipping, or you can say that friction is sufficient for no slipping. Friction is large enough for pure rolling. Fine. So if this happens, you have to tell me these things: acceleration of center of mass, alpha, and the force of friction between the solid sphere, right? So it was a solid sphere. By the way, whenever in the question it is just written sphere, take it as solid sphere. They sometime may not mention that it is a solid. Okay, the solid sphere is there. Find out ACM, alpha, and FR. All of you. First step is draw the free body diagram. Have you drawn the free body diagram? Done with the free body diagram, all of you. Those who are done, type in free body diagram. Done. Okay. So I'll also draw the free body diagram. If you think that you are done with the free body diagram, continue. So mg force from the center of mass, you need to be very particular about the point of application of the force also when you draw the free body diagram of a rigid body. This is mg. Okay, normal reaction from the surface like this. Friction. Now sometimes you will wonder which direction the friction will act. Okay, so don't worry about it. Just assume any direction. Don't break your head by which direction the friction will be, top or bottom and all that. Doesn't matter. If you assume it to be a wrong direction, friction will come out to be negative and you will know at the end. Don't worry much. Then you should show the acceleration also, because they are asking you to find out that. So this is ACM and there will be angular acceleration. Let's say this is my angular acceleration. Use a different color. So this is my alpha. How many of you got this correct? Free body diagram. Different direction for friction. Now, can you actually tell me that is there a way to, without even solving the question, can you tell in this direction which direction the friction will be? Up or down? Without solving, can you tell? Why it will be up? Why it has to be up? The reason is what? That is one way. Another way is that torque about center of mass should not be zero. You can see mg and normal reaction, both of them passes through the center of mass. So friction is the only one which is creating torque, and torque is equal to I alpha, right? So torque should be able to create alpha in that direction. Then only it will roll down. Do you understand that? Do you understand that? Friction should create a torque in this way, so that the sphere can rotate like that and go down. Clear? Now I want you to write down the equations. Let's say this is my y-axis, this is x-axis. X and y, okay? So I want you to write net force along x-axis to be equal to mass times acceleration along the x-axis. And net force along y-axis, mass into acceleration along the y-axis. Let me know once you're done writing these two equations. acceleration of the center of mass we have to take. Then you might have to take components of mg. Okay, only Archit is done. Others? Anybody else? Okay, do you get this along x-axis? Mg sine theta minus friction is equal to m into acm, and along the y-axis n minus. Do you think that this is any different from whatever you have been doing till now? It's the same thing, right? You got this equation, right? Now you have to write torque equal to I alpha. Is there a fixed axis here? Is there a fixed axis? Is there a fixed axis? What is the velocity? If it is pure rolling, okay? What is the velocity of this point at the bottom? If it is pure rolling, what is the velocity of that point? This point velocity should be zero or not? Surface is at rest. Do you all agree that point of contact velocity should be zero? Right? So that point is at rest. That point is at rest. So that is the fixed axis. But that is a different type of fixed axis. It is instantaneously at rest. Instantaneous fixed axis. Okay. So this point, don't know how to describe that. For example, you have something rolling, you know, this object is rolling. This point right now, it is at rest. As soon as it rolls little bit, this point is replaced by that point. This point is replaced by that point. Now, earlier this point was at rest. Now this point is at rest. And then this point is at rest. At rest as it rolls forward and forward. Okay, but then, you know, I'm just telling you for your knowledge. Later on, once you get comfortable with a lot of problem solving, you can use this. But right now, let us assume that there is no fixed axis. And anyways, if you are not sure, you should play safe and write down this equation about the center of mass axis. Okay, so write down this equation, all of you, and let me know once you're done. Torque equation about the center of mass, write down. Those who are done typing. What is the torque about center of mass? How much it is? How much is the torque about the center of mass? Right? Torque in terms of force, how much it is? You have to find torque, right? Torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance. What it is that? How much it is? Did you calculate the torque in terms of all the forces acting on it? How much it is? No one? Which force is mg creating torque about center of mass? Which force is creating torque? How much? Torque due to friction is how much? Acha, radius is r. What is the perpendicular distance of friction from the center? Perpendicular distance of friction from the center is how much? R, right? R is a perpendicular distance. So torque is R into Fr. Perpendicular distance into force. That is the definition of the torque, right? Now, this should be positive or not. That depends on alpha. Direction of alpha you take positive, not clockwise, anti-clockwise. Okay, just like you write net force is equal to mass m acceleration, direction of acceleration you take positive. Similarly here, r into fr, icm is what? I think most of you got this, 2 by 5 mr square into alpha. Okay, so friction is equal to 2 by 5 mr alpha. Any other equation other than these? Any other equation? Consider an equation for pure rolling, right? So alpha r should be equal to acm, pure rolling on a fixed surface. So friction is equal to 2 by 5 m acm, which you can put over here. You will get mg sin theta minus friction, minus 2 by 5 macm is equal to macm. So acm is equal to 5 by 7, right? No, 5 by 7 g sin theta. This is acm. All of you understood this? Type in quick. Is this clear? Go through this entire thing. Tell me, what is the frictional force? How much friction is required? What is the friction required? Friction we already know, 2 by 5 m into acm, which is 5 by 7 g sin theta, right? So this is equal to 2 by 7 mg sin theta. All right, this is the rolling friction. This is the amount of rolling friction that is applied on it. Getting it? This much. Only this much friction will be applied. This much. All right. And if coefficient of friction is mu, maximum friction is how much? F max is equal to mu times normal reaction, which is mg cos theta. So mu mg cos theta should be greater than or equal to 2 by 7 mg sin theta. Otherwise rolling won't happen, because for rolling this much friction is must. If this much friction is not there, rolling won't happen. Okay, I hope things are clear. Clear, right? Friction is this. You have to substitute ACM there. You'll get the value of friction. ACM, you got it? right? Okay. So, fine. Now we can take the questions. This one we just did. Do this. Both the tensions are equal because of the symmetry. Anyone close to the answer? Kinshuk got something? From the side, how does it look like? It looks like this, a circle and a string over the top. It'll look like this. All of you agree? Right? One string will be front, one string will be behind. So it'll be T and T, two T's. There will be MG force like this. Okay, any other force? Any other force? No, only tension and MG are there. So do you think that it will roll like this, everyone? Do you think it should roll like that? The cylinder will, the wrap will open up, everybody, angular equation alpha, and it will accelerate like that ACM down. Okay, so now just write down the equations. Nothing is left now. Vertical direction, net force is mg minus 2t is equal to m into ACM. Okay, this is the force equation. You have to write the torque equation also. Now to write out the torque equation, you can say, if you are not very sure about this being the fixed axis, which it is, you can say torque about the center of mass is equal to ICM into alpha. So what is the torque about the center of mass, everyone? What should I write instead of this? T into R or no? 2TR. Two strings are there, right? Which are creating torque on the cylinder. ICM is how much? How much is ICM for the cylinder? ICM is what? MR square by 2. Right? That into alpha. Any other equation you can think of that I'm missing here? Anything else? T is equal to MR by 4 times alpha. Any other equation that you think we should write over here? Everyone. What is the relation between alpha and ACM? Is there any relation? This point on the string is at rest, right? So it is like rolling without slipping only. So that point is at rest. So that point on the cylinder should also be at rest. Okay. So ACM should be equal to alpha into R. So tension will come out to be M ACM by 4. Okay. So then you write down MG minus 2 times of tension, M ACM by 2 is equal to M ACM. So 3 by 2 ACM is equal to G. So ACM is 2G by 3. If ACM is 2G by 3, the tension value is M by 4 into 2G by 3. So tension is MG by 6. Now go through this question, all of you. It's a very important question. Step by step, go through it and realize that we have not done anything new. All right. All of you, spend maybe a minute on it. Once you're clear, type in that it is clear. Clear? Yeah. R alpha is equal to ACM. That's what we did. Type it quickly. Is it clear? Entire question solution now clear? देखो जी, दिस थिंग इज यू आर आस्किंग मी हाउ आई एम कैलकुलेटिंग. यू शुड बी जस्ट हैप्पी दैट आई हैव रिटन दीज इक्वेशंस एंड नाउ यू सॉल्व इट योरसेल्फ. दीज आर द इक्वेशंस, डू इट योरसेल्फ. व्हाई यू आर आस्किंग हाउ इट इज 2 + 3, व्हाई यू डू व्हाट यू हैव डन, हाउ यू सब्स्टिट्यूटेड दिस एंड दैट. यू सॉल्व दीज लीनियर इक्वेशंस, राइट? आई एम नॉट हियर टू टेल यू हाउ टू सॉल्व लीनियर इक्वेशंस. Understand that you have to do it, otherwise the same thing will happen in the exam also. Fine. So all I have done is I have substituted R alpha as ACM, so T is equal to MACM by 4. Okay, do it yourself, do it yourself, then only it will be good for you. All right, otherwise the same thing is written in the book also. You can as well copy it from the book, solution book. Right? If we consider string to be surface, and should we also consider frictional force? Tension is there, na? That's like a friction force only. Tension is due to the friction only, you can say. All right, let's go to next. Write down the equations and solve them. First, nicely draw the favor diagram and write down the equations, all of you. What about B? What about B? What about it? Achha, B, what is the speed of cylinder as it falls through height h? Tell me, how will you do the B part? Once you do the A part, what do you do with the B? How will you get it? Now it is, acceleration is this, constant acceleration. So you have to use V square equal to U square plus 2AS. Use that. V is equal to root of 2 A into H. That is the answer. Do this. Have you drawn the free body diagram? Okay. Have you written the equations also? Did you get the answer as well? All of you do this. Which direction the friction will act? Right or left? You can't say. Looking at the question, you can't say anything. Okay. Just assume any direction. Fine. Let's say you assume that direction to be friction. This is friction. Downward direction will be mg. This is the normal reaction. All right. So ACM is this way. This is ACM. And alpha is this. How many of you got the free body diagram correct? Got it? Okay, great. Many of you got it. So write down the force equation along the x-axis. Force equation along x-axis will be what? F minus force of friction. This will be equal to M into ACM. Right? This is the first equation. Vertical direction N minus MG is equal to zero. Second equation. Right? Now torque equation. What is the torque about the center of mass? I have to write torque about center of mass to be equal to ICM into alpha. Tell me what you will get torque as about the center of mass. What will be the torque? So which are the forces that are creating torque? Is mg creating any torque? It passes through the center of mass, no perpendicular distance. Normal reaction, no. What about small f? Yes. Capital F, yes. Both small f and capital F, they are creating torque. Are they creating torque in the same direction or in opposite direction? Torque, I'm asking. They are trying to rotate in the same direction, right? So when you find the torque, you have to add them up, right? So F into R is a torque due to capital F, and small f into R is a torque due to the small f. They will both add up because in the same direction. This is equal to ICM. It's a sphere. So 2/5. MR square into alpha. This is the third equation, right? And it is rolling without slipping, written. So I can say that ACM is equal to alpha R. Now all of you solve these four equations, get the answer quick. I'm not here to teach you how to solve these four equations. Physics is still here only. All of you solve this linear equation, get the answer quick. Okay, Weber already got it. Others? Okay, Gayatri got something. Archit, how can you subtract 5R from 2? Don't you think dimensionally it doesn't make sense? Small f is not given. Okay, you have to find in terms of capital F. In fact, even R is not given. Radius is also not given. You can see how pathetic the situation is. You guys are not able to solve the linear equations. So you should be doing these calculations yourself. Otherwise, you'll never learn. Fine. Nobody will come and suddenly magic will happen and you start doing the calculation your own property. You can see you're not able to solve. All the equations are in front of you. Any other answer? This R gone. So we have capital F plus a small f to be equal to 2 by 5 m into ACM. Fine. And we have capital F minus a small f is equal to m into ACM. So if you add them up, you'll get 2f is equal to 7 by 5 m ACM. So ACM is 10f by 7. Okay, so Gayatri and Vaibhav got it. This is ACM. Now just substitute the value of ACM in any of these two equations, you'll get the value of friction also. Everybody understood? Small f is not given. Small f is your assumed variable. Look at the question, only capital F is given and small m is given. Go through it, all of you. Tell me, is it clear? Friction comes out to be negative. So friction is in the same direction as capital F, opposite of what you have assumed. Clear to everyone? Now we'll move to the next question. Read the question and tell me, will the tension on both sides of the string, both sides of the pulley, tension on the string will be equal or different? Pulley has mass and friction both. It is not an ideal pulley. It is rotating. It has an angular acceleration. Fine. So the tension will be different. Otherwise, the net torque about the center of the pulley will be zero. It will not be able to rotate then. This is, let's say, T1. This is T2. Different tensions. Now solve it, get the answer. When we assume same string, same tension, we also assume pulley is frictionless and has no mass. Write down the equation and let me know once you're done. Equations written. No worries. I'm not hurrying up. When you guys don't respond, then I'll go with my pace. If you say that spend some more time, I'll spend more time. Okay. I want you to speak up. Anybody done with the equations? Kinda. What is kinda? Kind of. So I hope you have drawn the free body diagram at least. This is Mg, this is a normal reaction. This is T2, this is T2, T1, T1, Mg. How many of you got this free body diagram correct? Fine. So now let's say acceleration of this block is small a. What is the acceleration of that block down? How much it will be? Is it a only? The reason is what? What is the reason? String has fixed length, constraint. It has nothing to do with friction or force or anything like that. Forget about that. It is a constraint equation. All right. Then this cylinder or the pulley will rotate. Angular acceleration is, let's say, alpha. Fine. What is the relation between A and alpha? About this fixed point, the entire pulley is rotating. So what is the relation? If radius is r, radius is small r given. Do you all understand that ACM, there is no ACM here. Okay. is A only. A is equal to alpha R. This point should move with alpha into R. Pulley is not rolling without slipping. You have to understand, this is different. The tip of the pulley is moving in a circle of radius small r. So if alpha is angular acceleration, tip has an angular acceleration of alpha into r. And that tip is in contact with the string, which is moving with A. So that is why both of them are equal. A is equal to alpha r, otherwise slipping will happen. Okay. Now we can write down the equations, right? So we have for capital M, mg minus T1 is equal to m into A. Okay. For small m, we have T2 is equal to small m into A. And for the pulley, what is the torque? Torque in terms of T1, T2, what it is? In terms of T1 and T2, tell me the torque. Torque due to T1 is T1 into R, T1 into small r. Okay, T1 into small r. Torque due to T2 is in the same direction or in opposite direction? Opposite, right? So T1 into R minus T2 into small r. There's a net torque. There's a net torque in the direction of alpha. This net torque is equal to I times alpha. Okay. So we have one equation, two, three, and four. All of you solve this, get the answer quick. Just getting the equations is not enough. Solving them also is important. Oppose. Anybody got the answer? Any guesses how to solve this? Okay. T1 minus T2 is this. You can see if I use these two equations, I'll directly get the value of T1 minus T2. Okay, so mg minus T1 plus T2 is equal to capital M plus small m into A. Okay, so from here, T1 minus T2 is equal to mg minus capital M plus small m into A. So substitute this in place of T1 minus T2 and use alpha is equal to A by R, you'll get the value of acceleration. Okay. Understood? So let me go to the next question now. Okay, here the rod is in equilibrium, alpha is zero. This is similar to what we had done last class. Draw the free body diagram and let me know once you're done. Done with the free body diagram. No one? What is the direction of? Let's say I draw a rod like this. Direction of normal direction over this point. Which one it will be? How? How the normal direction over here will be? At this point. No one? It will be perpendicular, right? Perpendicular to both the planes of the contact. Now there is no plane of contact for the wall. There's a roller there. So perpendicular to the rod you have to take like this. This is your N1. Okay? This is your N2 from here. This is your N2. And frictional force this way. How much friction be acting over there? It is about to slip. What is the friction? How much? How much would be the friction force? Mu mg. No. Mu N2. Okay. There'll be Mg. Mg from where? Center of mass. Okay. Mg from center of mass will be acting down. So this is Mg. M is not given. Okay. This is Mg. This force. All right. Now, the net force is zero and net torque is also zero about every point. So, see, I want you to solve this question, get the answer yourself. Then only you'll feel confident. If I keep on solving, you keep on noting down in your notebook, it is not going to help you. Okay, it is waste of your effort. Okay, it's a donkey's job to just copy whatever is written word by word. Right? Do it yourself. Even if you get it wrong, doesn't matter. Try this. Distance between forces and center of mass, you can find out, right? The center of mass is at a distance of L by 2. H is given, this H is given, use it. Geometry. Okay, let me tell you what I want from you. I want these three equations. Net force along x-axis should be equal to zero. It is in equilibrium. Net force along y-axis should be equal to zero. And I want torque about this point P. This torque point P is equal to zero. These three equations I want. All right. Let me know once you're done with these three equations. No one got it? Equations. No one is able to write. No, I don't want to see the equation. Just tell me that you're done. It may be right or wrong, doesn't matter. Okay, do it, complete it. Done. Archit is done. Others? Shabda is done. Others? Done. Kinshuk is also done. Ritu is done. All right. So net force along x-axis is how much? You need to resolve N1 into two components. Which component is this? N1 cos theta or sin theta? This angle is how much? This angle how much? 90 theta, right? So I will get mu N2 minus N1 sin theta, that is cos of 90 minus theta, that is sin theta, is equal to 0. The net force along x-axis, 0. Along the y-axis, we have N2 plus N1 cos theta minus mg. All right, this is equal to 0. All right, now the torque equation about point P. Why I have to choose point P? Because torque due to N2 and mu N2 will become 0 that way. Fine, so it will become easy to handle. You have to find torque due to lesser number of forces. So torque about point P, if I write it to be 0, I'll get, what is the torque due to N1 about point P? You can find torque by N1 cos theta or N1 sin theta separately. You can also find the torque by entire N1 together. That will be better because entire N1 is perpendicular. So torque due to N1 is N1 into, what is this distance from P to this distance? This is a perpendicular distance, right? This is the perpendicular distance from here to here. How much is this? H by sine theta. H divided by sine theta. They are torque due to N1. Which direction the torque is? The torque is in this direction. It is trying to rotate that way. Okay. So mg torque is in opposite direction. That is mg into what? Its perpendicular distance is how much from the point? This is MG's line. Its perpendicular distance will be this. This is how much? This is the perpendicular distance, right? You drop a perpendicular on line of MG. That is a perpendicular distance, which is how much? From here to there, it is L by 2. So that is L by 2 cos theta. So mg into L by 2 cos theta, right, is equal to 0. This is your torque equation. How many of you got this torque equation? Okay, great. Mg's torque is Mg into its perpendicular distance from point P. Perpendicular distance is you have to drop a perpendicular on line of Mg. So which is this? So there is a right angle triangle. This distance is L by 2. This is theta. So this perpendicular distance is L by 2 cos theta. Okay. Fine. Now from here you can get the value of N1. N1 is equal to Mg L by 2h tan theta. No, not tan theta, sin theta cos theta. This is N1. So substitute the value of N1 over here, you'll get N2. Okay, then put both N1 and N2 there, you'll get the value of mu. That is what they're asking. Okay, everyone just go through this and tell me whether clear or not. Quickly type in. All right. Okay, then we'll take a break now and meet after the break. Is this mains level? I don't know. You can't say something is mains level or advanced level, because in mains level, there will be 30 to 40% questions in the mains paper will be advanced level. And in advanced paper, 30% of the questions will be mains level. So how can you just look at a question and say this is mains level, advanced level? But then yes, in advanced paper, more questions will be difficult. In mains paper, lesser questions will be difficult. And in CET, even lesser number of questions will be difficult. But we are taking those questions which will help us understand the chapter better. Right now, our entire focus is understanding the concept, right? Because you guys are facing it difficult, that is the reason why you're learning. If you don't face the difficulty, if you are able to solve it quickly, if I ask you what is 2 plus 2, what is 5 plus 2, 5 minus 2, you'll be very happy. All the answers you'll get. But you're not learning anything if you get everything. Fine. So learning happens only when you don't get when you are during the learning. All right. So you'll start getting these questions right once you practice a lot of questions yourself. After the class, during the class, nobody can master the concepts just sitting in the class, not doing anything after the class. That will never ever happen. It's not like your class 9th and 10th. Okay. Fine then. So we'll meet after couple of minutes and we'll meet at 6:24. Okay, here's the question. Kinshuk got something. What do you think, Kinshuk? Is it correct? Anybody else? Any other answer? All right. What is the acceleration of the string? See, it cannot be a because it is dimensionally incorrect. Alpha into r can be a. Alpha by r dimensionally cannot be a. Tell me, what is the acceleration of this? Let's say acceleration of this point is lower disk is alpha, right? And ACM is the center of mass of the lower disk. This is ACM. Okay. So if alpha is the acceleration, let's say alpha, this is alpha, this is, let's say, alpha 1. So acceleration of this point P will be what? Alpha into r, alpha 1 into r, right? All of you agree? If alpha 1 is the angular acceleration of the upper cylinder, then this point P's acceleration down will be alpha 1 into r. Okay? Now, with respect to this point, this point is going down with an acceleration of alpha into r. You need to add this point's acceleration also, alpha 1 into r, and then say this is equal to ACM. Okay, with respect to this point, it is going down by alpha into r with respect to that point P. Okay. You need to add the point P's acceleration also to get the total acceleration of the center of mass. Everybody understood this equation? Is it clear to everyone? Right? Now, what is the relation between alpha 1 and alpha? What is the relation? Why do you think it is equal? Why they are equal? Because it is the constraint between these two points, all right? The constraint equation is that they both alpha for both the rigid bodies to be equal. So actually answer B is correct, not C or A, all right? See, the thing is that I'll tell you another reason why their alphas are equal. For example, if you look at the above one, they are identical disks, okay? Above one, tension T is this way. So with respect to center, the torque is what? T into R. This will be equal to I into alpha 1. For the below one, with respect to center of mass, you have again same torque, T into R. This is equal to I into alpha. So torque is same, T into R with respect to center of mass. There will be mg, but mg is passing through the center of mass. Because torques are equal and moment of inertia are also equal, as they are identical, their alphas are also equal. Okay. This you can say CT or mains level. Right, something like this we had done earlier, but now also we should practice this. Do this. Okay. I think this question is little ambiguous in the wordings. I will change the wordings of the question. Just ignore this. Sorry about that. I'll just change the question. Everyone, don't do this. Something like this we have already done earlier, but I thought we'll do it again. There is this rod of mass m, length l. It is hanging by using two strings, fine, symmetrically placed, these two strings. And also there is a mass small m attached from the center. Okay, and this center, from the center with a string, mass m is attached. So what you're doing is you're cutting this string. Immediately after cutting, you have to find the tension on the other string, how much it is. Find out. Immediately after cutting, by the way, you can say that it acts like as if this point P is the fixed axis. Immediately after cutting, it will try to rotate like that. That you can say. Let's do step by step, get the value of angular acceleration of the rod immediately after cutting the string. Or more basic than that, first draw the free body diagram. Then we'll write the equations. Let me know once you are done with the free body diagram and the equations. That's all. How many of you have done the free body diagram? Free body diagram. Okay. there will be a tension from here, T. There will be a force of capital MG. What else? Any other force? What should I write? Small mg force acts on small m or on the rod? Who is applying mg force? Who applies mg? Earth is applying mg. Is it applied on the small m or on the rod? On the small m. So what force the rod feels? What force rod feels? Tension, right? Tension need not be mg every time. Let's say there is a force T1. Okay? And I can show that there is this direction rotation will happen. This is alpha. Okay? What will be the acceleration of center of mass immediately after cutting in terms of alpha? Can I say that? Anything? In terms of alpha, what is the acceleration of center of mass immediately after cutting? Alpha into L by 2 is ACM. Okay. Now vertical direction. What is the equation in vertical direction? Force equation. Mg plus T1 minus T is equal to mass times acceleration of center of mass. All of you understand this equation? Type it. Have you understood this equation? Clear? Okay. Now there is a torque equation. Torque equation you can either write about the fixed axis or about the center of mass axis also. All right. So it is up to you. So we can write about the fixed axis. It will be T1 plus mg. This into L by 2. How much is the moment of inertia? What should I write here? M into moment of inertia rod about this point. How much should I write? ML square by 3 I into alpha. Second equation. But there are three variables, T1, T and alpha. How to get the third equation, everyone? What is the third equation? T1 is equal to mg. Why? Is it small m accelerating or not? Everyone, is small m accelerating or not? This is small m that is kept there. Is it accelerating or not? How much is the acceleration of that? It is connected with the center of mass only. So whatever is the acceleration of center of mass will be the acceleration of small m, right? So the equation will be small mg minus T1 is equal to mass times acceleration. This is the third equation. Now you have to just solve them and get the answer. Go through these equations. Let me know. Is it clear or not? Now you can see that you can't put a tension as mg every time because there is an acceleration also. Type in, is it clear? I'm giving you 1 minute to go through. No, Archit, if you write about center of mass, torque, you'll get the same equation, which is a linear combination of 1, 2, and 3. It is not a new equation. Okay? If you write about center of mass. Clear to everyone, type it quick, then we can go to the next one. Raghav, Pranav, Meghna, Madhumati, Kiran, Ritu, Ruchita, Sambhu, Shrigori, Vaibhav, Vignesh. Can you answer? Or you are here to just sit? I'm asking something, all of you. Akshat, Amrita, two Akshats. Adarsh, everyone should answer. I'm waiting. I'll see who is not answering. I have to do something. Dev Bantia, you want me to take your name? Then you'll answer something. Do you think I should keep on calling your names? Then only you'll speak up. All of you answer, is it clear? If it is not, what is the doubt? Okay, almost everybody has answered. Let me check who hasn't. Sometime I wonder whether you guys are sitting there or not. Throughout the class, if you just keep quiet, it is as good as you watching the recording. So why are you attending live classes? Go and see the recordings. Okay, still, I think some of you haven't answered my question. Who is it? Rishika, please answer. Ruchita, you're quiet throughout the class. You don't speak a thing. Why? Vignesh Madan, in caps. Should I ask you separately? Ruchita is there or not? Vignesh Madan, there or not? Looks like you're not there, Vignesh. Vignesh, Sinchan. Sinchan is there. Vignesh is not there. Okay, Druti, you're there? Druti is there, okay. All right, so I'll have to call Vignesh, see why he's not there. All right, let's move forward. Because just sitting, it is very easy to hide. All right, and it is very easy for me to ignore also. Why should I care whether you're hiding or not? It is so easy for me to just ignore. Okay, fine, let them hide. I don't care. And I'll just continue. But ultimately, you'll be at loss if I ignore or you don't speak up in the class. It's a complete loss for you, not to me. So I don't know how many times I have to say that. Okay. Or I should just start ignoring that some of you are not speaking at all. All right, do this, all of you. It's a very similar question, the one which you had just done, right? So all of you should get the answer. In fact, this one is simpler than the previous. Devrajan already got some answer. Others? Shambhu got it. But both of you are getting different answers. So one of you is wrong. Both of you check your calculations. All right, others, have you drawn free body diagram? See, I don't remember the answer and I'm doing this question for the first time myself. I solve questions with you as a student whenever I do that. So that you also think like it. We can discuss the difficulty faced during the problem solving. So the free body diagram, this is the free body diagram. This is T, this is MG. Okay. Okay, continue solving. I'll just write down the equations. If I release it, center of mass will have acceleration or not? Center of mass will have acceleration or not? how much if angular acceleration is alpha, how much is the acceleration of center of mass? ACM is what? Alpha into r by 2, right? Alpha into r by 2 is ACM. So what is the equation you'll get? Net force equal to mass m acceleration in vertical direction, what you'll get? Tell me. What kind of equation you'll get? Anyone wants to type it? Equation in vertical direction. Can you type it? What you have written? Okay. Net force mg minus t is equal to mass times ACM. ACM is alpha into L by 2. Okay, this is the force equation. Do you all understand this, everyone? Mass m acceleration of center of mass is equal to net force in vertical direction. This is a Newton's second law equation from laws of motion. Okay, this is not something which you have learned in this chapter. We have learned this already in laws of motion. Now we'll write torque equation. That is what we have learned in this chapter. Torque is equal to I alpha. About which axis should I write this equation? Is there a fixed axis? Is there a fixed axis? P is a fixed axis. Should I write about P? Should I write about P? Which one would be better or easier for you? Writing torque equation about O or writing torque equation about P? Which one will be easier for you? Which one, the torque equation, which one will be easier? P. Do you know you need to find moment of inertia about P? If you write torque equal to I alpha about P, you need to find moment of inertia about P. Yes or no? Do you know that? You have to use parallel axis theorem to apply moment of, to find out moment of inertia about P. So unnecessary, why to get in trouble? Write down torque equation about the center of mass. Okay. So it will be T into R by 2. This is equal to I alpha. I is what? Mr square by 2. Mr square by 2 into alpha. Right? So this is gone. That is gone. So T is equal to Mr alpha. So substitute that. You will get Mg is equal to 3 by 2 M. What is this L by 2? This is R by 2. 3 by 2 MR alpha. So from here, alpha is 2G by 3R. This is alpha. We need to find tension. Tension is MR alpha. So 2 by 3 MG. Anybody got this answer? See? Okay, good. Madhumati got it, Shraddha got it, Ritu got it. Only girls are able to solve. Any? Others? Nobody else? Kinshuk, you got anything? All right, you got B. Now you understand, right? All of you understand your silly errors? Go to the next question. this exact question will never come in the exam. All right, don't try to be in the mode where you just try to understand every question, how it is solved, and then you'll not be able to do in exam. You should be understanding how to use a concept in any scenario. Okay, do this. Length from pin A. It is 1/4. This is L/4. Again, a repetitive question, right? This is the third question which is similar continuously. Don't worry about your school exams for this chapter. School questions will be a lot simpler than this. You'll find it very, very simple now. You have done many different varieties and types of questions. Anybody for part A? Did you get the value of alpha? How much will be the angular acceleration? You can write torque about the pin is equal to I alpha now, because a force from the pin is not known. That pin is a fixed axis. So even if there is a force from the pin, torque due to that force will be zero about the pin axis. Should I wait or solve? Anybody about to get the answer? Any other force on the rod? Any other force on the rod? Tell me. Any other force should I show on the rod? I've drawn a free body diagram for you. Do you think any other force should I show in the rod immediately after cutting the cable? No one knows. What do you think, Archit? Shraddha, Madhumati, do you think any other force other than these two? Force due to the hinge and force due to the gravity. Any other force other than these two? Why I have taken vertical direction force? Why not there will be a horizontal direction force? Why not from the pin a force horizontally? What is the problem? I can say there are two components of forces from the hinge, F1 and F2. Why not? It's not hinge about the end point. So what? From wherever it is hinge, no problem. Why you've taken vertical force only? Why not horizontal force from the hinge? It's not a normal reaction, right? It is not a normal reaction. It's a pin. That pin can apply force in any direction. You can say one component vertical, one component horizontal. Yes or no, everyone? But F2 is zero. But F2 is zero. What is the reason F2 is zero? What's the reason? As that's the only force horizontally, net force along x direction is F2 only, which is equal to mass time acceleration of center of mass along x direction. What is the acceleration along x direction? Everyone, over here, what is the acceleration along x direction? It is zero. That is why F2 is zero. But suppose it gains some angular, suppose angular velocity omega would have been there. All right, then F2 would have been equal to, okay, F2 should be in opposite direction actually. So minus of F2 would have been m omega square L by 4, because omega square L by 4 is a centripetal acceleration of the center of mass. Do you all understand whatever I have just told you? There is no acceleration there is, because omega is zero right now. So there is no centripetal acceleration. But if omega would not have been zero, then there would be a horizontal component of the force also from the hinge. All of you are able to understand the reason why only F1 is there, right? So if omega is there, there will be centripetal acceleration. So there will be F2 then. Right now, F2 is zero. All right. So if after releasing, alpha is the angular acceleration, what is the acceleration of center of mass? what it is. ACM is what? Accession center of mass. How much? Alpha into L by 4. Okay? Right? So vertical direction, I can say that mg minus F1 is equal to mass times acceleration of center of mass. Yes. Right. And now I can write the torque equation. Which torque equation will be better suited? You have fixed axis also and center of mass axis also. Which one do you think will be better? Center of mass, otherwise you have to find moment of inertia about this fixed axis, right? So F1 into L by 4, but you'll get the same value of alpha both ways. Remember that. This is equal to M L square by 12 into alpha. Okay? So this is 3. One of the L is gone. So F1 is equal to M alpha L by 3. All right? So Mg is equal to M alpha L 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4. So M is gone. So alpha is equal to 12 G by 7 L. This is alpha, right? So what is the acceleration of end B immediately after cutting? In terms of alpha, tell me how much it will be. In terms of alpha, what is the acceleration of B? Alpha into? In what radius? This from here to here, the distance is 3L by 4. Right, so this point B is moving in a circle of 3L by 4. So alpha into 3L by 4. So what answer you are getting when you do that? Which answer? A, B, C, D. That much at least you can tell. No. This into 3L by 4. You get option A, right? Reaction at pin is what? F1, right? So once you get that value, you can write down the value of, once you know this is the acceleration, alpha is known to you. F1 is M alpha L by 3, right? So 12 by, so you get 4 by 7 up. What happened, Kinshuk? Last question for today. Not today, last question for the entire week. We unfortunately will not be able to meet for the next week because of the Dashera holidays. So, last question for 2 weeks now, this one. Second part, they're asking you what is F1. Okay. In the previous question, they're asking you what is the reaction at pin. Reaction at pin is F1. Okay. And F1 is M alpha L by 3. Alpha, you already got. Put the value of alpha here, get F1. Okay. Do this. tell me, the normal reaction should act from where? Should act from B by 2 upwards? Is it required that it should act like this? No, that's not required. When it is about to tip over, I'm giving you a hint, okay, to solve the question. So when it is about to tip over, normal reaction will act from where? Leftmost point, edge. Good. Corner. Because the entire surface will be slightly lifted up when it is about to topple. Isn't it? It will be as if from here to here, the surface lifted up and everything is trying to get rotated about that point. So normal reaction will shift this side. That is the condition for it to be tipping over, started to tipping over, normal reaction shifting to the corner. That is the condition. Okay, now do it. No one got the condition? No one got the answer? Okay, let me do it. Minimum force is that force at which alpha is just greater than zero. Tipping over means what? Tipping over means alpha is more than zero. It's started rotating about the edge. About this point, P, it has started rotating. So alpha is there. So the condition for the minimum, this thing would be that the alpha is almost zero about point P. All the torques are balanced. If you increase force little bit, torque will be greater than zero and then it will just topple over. Okay. And normal reaction will be shifted here anyways. I hope all of you have drawn the free body diagram. Okay. Only force left is mg. Mg will be always acting from the center of mass. Doesn't matter tipping over or whatever it is. For mg, it doesn't matter. Okay. Now friction is also there. So we will be taking friction like this. This is friction. How much friction will be there, everyone? Will it be maximum friction? Yes, because it is already sliding, moving with constant velocity, right? you need to find greatest height the force will be applied to. Let's say this is y. This distance is, let's say, y. So torque about point P should become equal to zero. And if you increase the force, it should become greater than zero. That's how it will be. So torque about point P for force F is how much? Force F, what is the torque with respect to P? F into? What is the perpendicular distance of F from P? Extend the line of force and drop a perpendicular on it. It will be Y only, right? So F into Y is the torque due to mg. Sorry, due to F. Due to mg will be what? Mg into? What is the perpendicular distance of mg from P? From P, mg is distance. Y by 2? No. It is B by 2. Extend the line of force of mg and drop a perpendicular on it. This is the perpendicular, right? This is the perpendicular. That is B by 2. So mg into B by 2. Will they add or subtract? They're in the same direction or opposite directions? Mg is trying to rotate it clockwise. F is trying to rotate in which direction? Anti-clockwise. So this minus that is equal to zero. All right. So you will get Y is equal to MGB by 2F. Fine. Now we have to substitute the value of F. So horizontally, there is no acceleration of center of mass, right? Testing the force, constant velocity. All right, it is a constant velocity. So F minus mu times normal reaction is equal to zero. Alpha is also zero, so acceleration of center of mass is zero. Fine. So F minus mu n is zero, and vertically, normal reaction minus mg is equal to zero. All of you able to understand what I'm doing here? So F is equal to mu times mg. These are the force equations. So substitute here the value of F as mg, mu mg. So mgb divided by 2 times mu mg. So you'll get B by 2 mu. All of you understood this question? Everyone type it. Is it clear? Okay, clear? Fine. Let us do one advanced level question now. Last question. So there is a, this is fixed, okay? Don't worry about that. This is fixed, but on top there is a plank. This plank, see, you don't need to solve, you just need to write the equation. All right, I'm just looking for the equation, nothing else. A force of F is applied. An angle theta. The mass of the cylinder is m, radius is r. It is a solid cylinder. This is mass small m. Okay. There is sufficient friction everywhere for no slipping. All right. So I want you to write down the equations only. Assume that this is alpha and the acceleration of center of mass is ACM. Fine. With respect to these, just draw the free body diagram and write the equation. Don't need to solve. Okay. Assume that the force is not very large. This plank remains horizontal. Assume that. You just need to write down the equations of motion, force equation and torque equations. All right. The plank is not rotating, so you don't need to write torque equation for the plank. Just write down the force equation for the plank. You need to write force equation for plank and force and torque equation for cylinder. This is what you have to do. Clear? Yes, Kinshuk, friction is there everywhere. Friction won't leave you. Should I write down? Have you drawn the free body diagram? At least free body diagram, all of you. Okay, good. Continue doing it. Meanwhile, I'll start. Some of you might be in a hurry for your vacations to start. Don't want to hold you back. How many of you got this free body diagram correct for the plank? it will accelerate also. Let's call it as acceleration A1. All right. Then we'll draw free body diagram for the cylinder. Here our cylinder. Yeah, this is a cylinder. Now we'll show the pair of force N1, pair of friction, then one normal reaction from the bottom, one friction from the bottom. Then what else? Is that it? Yeah, that's it. So this is the friction one. Normal one, normal two, FR two. Yes, MG, gravity. Gravity should be the first force. How can I forget that? Maybe class timings are over, so I'm started forgetting things. So gravity is mg. All right, you have ACM. Don't worry if you're not getting this at the first go. This is advanced level. I have to show you some advanced level, right? So that you should not ask whether it is advanced level or not, the other questions. This is alpha. All right. So now, this cylinder is rolling on a fixed surface. So I can quickly write down alpha into R should be equal to ACM because it is rolling on a fixed surface, right? That is there. So let me put this. And then I can write down the force equation for the cylinder. FR1 minus FR2 is equal to capital M into ACM. Torque equation for the cylinder, torque will get added up, both the frictions will try to rotate in the same direction. This will be equal to I into alpha. These are the force equations for the cylinder. Force equation for the plank will be F cos theta minus FR1 is equal to small m into A1, right? And vertical direction F sine theta plus N1 minus mg is equal to zero. Vertical direction equation may not be that useful. You may not be interested in finding N1, so that's why. Now we need to write, now count the variables, okay? Hold on, count the variables. You have FR1, FR2, ACM, alpha, then N1, what else? Is that it? N1, N2, Kanya, there is no N2. No, let me write down the variables here. ACM, A1, FR1, FR2, then alpha, FR1, FR2, ACM, alpha, and N1. So we have six variables and only five equations. Where is the sixth equation? We need six equations for six variables. What do you think it will be? No. Vertical direction for cylinder, another variable will come. N2 will come. Are you getting it? If you write vertical direction, N2 minus N1 minus mg. Although you got one more equation, but you got one more variable also. You need one more equation. Tell me. What will be the other equation? No slipping condition over here. Why you forget that? No slipping there. No slipping condition over there. Okay. Now tell me, what is the no slipping condition over there? What is the equation for that? What is the condition for no slipping between cylinder and the plank? What is the condition? What is the accretion of this point? Just look at the cylinder. Accretion of this point is what? Tell me. This point's accretion is what? With respect to center, it is alpha into r this way plus ACM. All of you agree? ACM is also this way. Do you all agree that this is the accretion of that point on the cylinder? Quickly type in. Okay, this should be equal to what? This should be equal to A1, accretion of the plank, because there is no slip. Okay, and ACM is anyway equal to alpha r. So 2 times ACM is equal to A1. Accretion of the plank should be 2 times accretion of the center of mass of the cylinder. Okay. All right, so today we have comprehensively covered almost every type of question that can exist. But then having said that, there will be small tweaking here and there, and you can still find some new varieties. And I'm sure that you are not, you still need a lot of practice. Fine, you're not as smooth as you should be before the exam, right? So you need a lot of practice. So vacations are in front of you. So you can either choose to enjoy vacation, all right, or you can choose to work towards your weakness and come out very strong the other side of the vacation. The choice is up to you. Okay, so I'm not strictly telling you to do anything. Just that I'm telling you that here is a chance for those who have fire in their belly, but they have lagged behind because they did not get the head start at the beginning. They might have taken probably class 11th not so seriously. Now they realized. Okay, so you have 10 days to look back upon and work on your strength, or you can enjoy vacation, close your eyes as if nothing is happening around you. Okay, but then I'm also not saying that you should 24 hours you just study. Okay, find out time to meet your friends, spend some time with your family, free time, but at the same time, do not just close the book for next 10 days. Okay, it'll be not cool. All right, so happy Dashara to all of you. We'll meet on the other side of the break, and I hope you'll come a lot more prepared after the break. Bye.